Several executive orders have been issued by President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, banning the migrant herdsmen, locally known as Balalo, from northern Uganda, rebuking them for indiscipline and land grabbing. The last executive order issued in July was set to expire on 30th of September. However, the Balalo continue occupying parts of Acholi land, something that has irked leaders from the region. Recently, the Clark South Member of Parliament in Amuru District, Gilbert Olanya, bitterly condemned the continued stay of the Balalo, vowing to ensure they vacate the place at whatever cost. Olanya was supposed to face the Uganda Human Rights Commission on allegations of hate speech and sectarianism.
So-called movement of clearing what Honorable Olanya is saying, is referring to as Balalo, to be divisive, sectarian, discriminatory, and unlawful.
After failing to show up at the commission chair has now issued summons against the legislator to appear before the commission not later than 6th of November. The same summons have been served to the Speaker of Parliament to ensure that Olanya does not abscond for the second time.
On Tuesday, he requested that he meets us today, and once again he has not come. We should know that Uganda is a diverse country with many ethnic groups. Actually, the constitution recognizes at least 56 ethnic groups. We also have almost 2 million refugees living here in the same country. And it is important that we all live together in peace and unity.
Wangadia advised other leaders from the Acholi region to avoid using hate speech and other illegal means to deal with the errant Balalo that have adamantly refused to go back home.
Concerned about the current trend, where leaders, especially elected leaders, have adopted incitement to hatred and discrimination against the people they call Balalo as a way of political mobilization, and any form of discrimination is unacceptable to us.
Shortly after the press conference, MP Gilbert Olanya was found making his way to the Uganda Human Rights Commission head offices in Nakasero, claiming he had just received the summons. He dismissed claims of prompting hate speech and sectarianism, but rather he was only trying to enforce the presidential order to have the Balalo vacate Acholi land.
The allegation put against me is quite baseless. For me, I am trying to re-echo what the president said. The president of Uganda, Yoweri Museveni, said Balalo must leave Acholi land. And the president has given the deadline, that is on the 15th of November. So we are trying to re-echo what the president said. And we are saying Balalo must leave.
He says the Balalo stay in northern Uganda has fueled land conflicts, since most of them are forcefully taking over land from the locals, on top of causing food insecurity in the region.
Are hiring land from the community of Acholi. After hiring land, from nowhere they turn and process the land titles into their name, instead of the land owners who gave them the land. Number two, the animals of Balalo are destroying our people's crop. Last Saturday, we witnessed one garden, about 5 acres. The cassavas were destroyed up to the ground level by the Balalo's animals. Not only that, currently, if Anacholi is buying animals from this side of Karoma, the animals bought by Anacholi is not allowed to cross Karoma and go to Acholi land. But the animals for Balalos are being cleared very fast, and their animals are being escorted by the military personnel. So what is the interest of government? What are the relationship of government and the Balalo?
The Balalo, a group of nomadic herdsmen majorly from the Ankole sub-region, who move from place to place looking for pasture for their cattle. With climate change and its diverse effects hitting the Ankole Masaka cattle corridor, the herdsmen have been forced to move to northern Uganda with fertile land rich with green pastures. Report compiled by Rachel Nachwala for the news.